Okay, hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today's episode, I'm going to introduce to you another man in my life, my younger brother, Yeonju Desalu, is passing through. He's going to Los Angeles, as a matter of fact, to vote. Yeonju, say hello to the audience.
Hello everyone, how are you doing? Can't stay long, gotta go, gotta vote. I'm with her.
I am with her.
Yeah.
Okay, so Yeonju is my younger brother, a year, 8 months, Abby?
I'm younger. Younger works.
Yes. Let's not get into details. Anyway, younger brother, it's myself, Yeonju, Ronke. Ronke is the youngest, so it's girl, boy, girl. Anywho, Yeonju has been married like forever. I love my sister-in-law, and he's the proud father of two girls and a boy. Love, love little Jagsy Pagsy. He's the youngest, and he's the little boy. Anywho, Yeonju was also born in Moscow, and we basically went to schools together, and we kind of separated when I came to London and you went to Albany.
Yeah.
That kind of thing.
Exactly.
Yes, because yeah, yeah. I went to Albany. Yeah, ACL. After after Maker College we left. So what can I tell you? He's a hot mess, but love him dearly. And he was the one I used to take his money for to buy makeup. I've been doing makeup for like years. He knows this. So I thought to myself, you know what? Let's have a Sunday special. And you can kind of, I can hear you screaming all kinds of questions. I'm so sorry, I can't hear you. So we're just gonna go through a little bit here and there. The first one being, because I don't want to talk too much, Yeonju, voting, politics, Obama's out. Is it Trump or is it Hillary? What are we working with here? Tell the audience.
I'm with her. However you want to read that. Ladies, I know there's lots of ladies out there voting their party lines.
Yeah.
You need to depart from that for this one.
Yes.
For this one, be true to your own gender. Can I say that on TV?
Yes, you can say that on TV.
Ladies, vote for Hillary.
Yes. Yeah. Ula says we shouldn't get too political here. Ula, are you for her or for him? Ula is playing safe.
Yeah.
I am for her. Mm-hmm. Yes, Yeonju, you are for... Yes. Yeonju and I are American citizens. Our mother is Gambian, our father is Nigerian. A lot of you might know this, but we grew up a lot. We stayed in America...
Decades.
Yeah.
Well, not for very long. See, we're still like heading towards our 30s.
Yes.
There we go.
Anywho, we are American citizens. Yeonju is from LA and I'm from New York because that was where we naturalized. So yes, we are big believers, regardless of the fact that we don't live in the country right now. We are heavy voters. You must vote. You don't vote, then you are silent and you can't complain afterwards.
There you go. You don't vote, you've just given up your chance to...
You've given up your chance.
What happens next.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You understand me? So we're moving on from there, okay? So that's what it is. A little bit, you know, of little politics here, there. Okay, Yeonju, you look very fabulous. Do you exercise? Do you diet? Do tell us about your physique.
Okay, just to make this look like uber professional. Fumi, what are you staring at? Do I stare at the camera? What am I supposed to really be looking at
here? I'm going to keep this inside. You're supposed to look at the camera.
Look at the camera.
The camera is your audience. The camera is the prettiest thing you've ever seen.
Okay, all right. Mm-hmm. So just pretend.
Just, it's yes. It's
a wifey.
Yes, it's
yes,
wifey.
I pretend it's Gan. It's really Gan. What's the question again?
The question was, because this channel is about fashion, beauty, lifestyle, health and fitness. You're starting.
So do I diet? Do I exercise?
Do you diet? Do you exercise?
I'm lousy at diets. I don't do that. Well, actually, diets don't work is what people... Mm-hmm. Well, sweet tooth from hell, first of all. So what I coast on is exercise.
Yes.
I exercise every day.
So what do you do? What kind of exercise?
I cycle, I run, I swim, I lift weights. Running after kids.
Yes, running after kids. That's a big one. After Jagsy. Yes. And after Fenty.
I saw it in
After Yinka.
Yeah. No, but no. Exercise, mandatory.
Yes.
Daily. Funny thing is, I become addictive. Addicted to
it's your
exercise.
Thing.
I love the way I feel after exercising.
Very good.
It's like I'm rushing to the gym, not necessarily just for the exercise alone.
Yes.
For the high I get after the intense workout.
Let me ask you, for me, when I'm exercising, my head is clear. I can bring in all of my thoughts, what I want to do, A, B, and C. But you are right. And I tend to, I don't know about you guys, once I've exercised, I tend to behave that day when it comes to eating. Like if I don't work out, I'll eat junk. But if I've worked out, I feel as if I've made all of this effort, I can't just go right there and eat a whole pizza. kind of thing.
Well,
that's not your tea.
Are we supposed to tell the truth?
Yes, a little bit.
After swallowing the Mars bar.
Yes.
That was meant for the kids at midnight.
Yes.
The only solace for me is like, Yanju, you're going to work it out tomorrow.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So that makes you feel better.
Yes.
So you eat the junk.
I eat the
promising
junk.
Promising yourself that you'll be at the gym.
I must be there tomorrow.
Okay.
And while I'm on there, well, you have the clear thought on whatever it is.
Yes.
I'm like, okay, good.
Okay.
I just got rid of the bagel.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to deviate now.
All right.
I get all kinds of questions from you. And I am such, I'm in such an opportune position where my followers range from the ages of 12 years old to the 70s, high 70s. I love it. But I got a random question the other day, and I'm going to spell it out because it's not really my flavor of language,
mm-hmm.
but I wanted to ask you.
Right.
One of the girls asked me, she said, Fumi, what do you do, or how do you respond or handle an F-U-C-K boy? Yes. So I said,
"For me, do you have viewers that are 12?"
Yes, that's why I said, "Their mothers will
edit
it up."
Exactly.
Yes. They will say, "No. It
what
was,
the hell is that?"
Yonju, hold on. She now told me I didn't know. Mm. I knew what the F they have.
Yeah.
So I said, "What was that?" She said, "That's boys that only want to do da do."
Why would you be? Why would you be in touch with anyone that's only interested in that?
Because she likes him.
Oh no no.
Yes.
Lord, give me, where's the vodka?
She wants to know. So I said, you know what? You being a guy, please.
A father.
Yes.
A man, but you were a single man before you started to chase this or whatever. Mm-hmm. You understand me? I love my girls. I love my audience. Mm-hmm. And I am not a guy. So I can't. And I did not know what that was.
Yeah.
So please.
Is this a young lady under 18?
No, this is a lady in her 30s.
You know, she could be any age, actually. Let me answer that straight from the heart.
Yes.
Why are you wasting your time?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Unless, of course, you're like this nymphomaniac from hell that has all the preventive paraphernalia or whatever
yes.
it is. But if you're looking for something to happen seriously down the line,
yes.
You know, so waste your time. He, and you can't fault the guys. He done told you.
You already know what he is. Straight out the gate.
I'm here for the candy. Straight up.
That's it.
Yeah. Get rid of him.
Get rid of him.
Immediately.
He's not even to be considered.
Wasting your time. And this is what I tell my own kids.
Mm.
Why give away something to someone that's not useful or important to you that you can never get back?
Well, you see, you know what it is. Let me start with her support.
Mm.
She's hoping that somehow or
that
the other,
that will turn into
a relationship.
No.
She can turn him around.
No.
That is actually love.
No.
They interpret that as love,
no.
affection, or whatever.
No.
It's a dead dog.
No.
Titanic.
No. No, 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 no.
Sink.
It's sunk. Gone. Wasting your time. And FYI,
yes.
Guys talk as much as girls do.
Mm.
Oh, sometimes. And in the locker room,
yes.
I'm like, when I see the ladies that people are referring to afterwards, I'm like, if only. So, hey.
Yeah.
No.
Adios. Gone. Alrighty.
And apart from that, I'll also throw in there, well, you would agree to this though also. You kind of attract what you put out there. So I would also take it personally, like, wait, hold up a minute. Why would you even want to be a friend with benefits?
You know what? I will add to that.
Mm-hmm.
You are what you put out there. Mm. It's shaky-bicky.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you don't put anything out there. You just get all kinds of frogs mixed in with the princes.
Okay.
So you have to kind of weed them out.
Gotcha.
Right there, you just cut the brick. Yeah, that's it. There are some people that I'm polite with,
mm-hmm.
and there are some people that I just slam the door.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? This is the wrong door you're knocking at.
Yeah.
Next.
Yeah.
Because sometimes they he tried it.
Yeah.
He
yeah.
tried it.
Yeah.
You understand
yeah.
me?
Yeah.
And sometimes because you're out there singles or whatever, people are trying each other
yeah.
to see what they can get.
No.
You need to pump the brakes
no.
right there and
yeah.
say, I'm not the one.
Yeah. And you can do it very politely, diplomatically,
uh-huh.
whatever it is. But somebody tells you that's what he's all about.
No, then we're not working with that.
Move on.
No. Okay, fashion, Yonju. Fashion. This is all about fashion. Are you a fashionable guy? Do you like style? What do you like to wear? Are you into brand names? Can you really, you know, go and just do like the street, high street trend or whatever? What is your thing?
Make
and
sure.
Do you wear color? Well, that's kind of like you understand me.
Well, wearing color now, yes. We know why, where the color came from. Yeah, I'm all about black because it hides dirt as well as anything else.
Yo, that's so disgusting.
Do I follow trends? Not really.
Okay.
Well, I'm lucky to have you and Ronikins because mm-hmm. you guys basically dressed me right throughout college till almost present day.
Yes.
But as far as following trends, no. I see stuff I like, but just because everybody else is wearing it doesn't mean I'm going to throw it on.
Yes. Yeah. So you're very so you're very classic, timeless. It doesn't have to be
the hot number.
No.
You hit the nail on the head. I prefer classic pieces.
That's your thing.
Yeah, things that you know you could wear forever and ever and ever. Like Daddy.
Yes, like Popsy. Like Popsy too. Yeah, yes, Daddy, yes. Yeah, okay. Yeah. All right, mm-hmm. we're working with something. Yeah. Coming to food, what do you like to eat? They know that I like all kinds of things because they've watched my About Me episode. Mm-hmm. So Yeonju, please tell us what you like to eat.
Keep me happy, very simple. Rice. Plantain. Rice fried plantains and put some beef on the side. I know I'm supposed to stay away from red meat, but hey, yes. everyone's entitled to some guilty sin.
Do you know what it is? Mm. I was doing my About Me and I was trying to be Zsa Zsa.
Yeah.
So I wanted to hit towards the lettuce, the salads or whatever. Ula in the background screamed, Rice. Don't tell lies.
Hey, it's the Gambian blood.
It's the Gambian blood.
No
so
rice.
It's rice.
Forget
so
it.
It's rice and it's plantain and it's beef. So like I said, we are half and half. Our mother is Gambia, we love her, she's from Banjul, and our father is Nigerian. We grew up in Lagos, Nigeria, and we went on holidays to Banjul, Gambia. Yeonju just came back from there about two, three weeks.
I know, pretty sad. We lost our uncle, so
yeah.
He was there for a burial.
Yeah.
Beautiful place though.
Yes.
Well,
it's our country.
Been. Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you just imagine waking up to the sound of the beach?
Always, all day
it's
long.
It's ridiculous.
It's beyond, yeah. beyond amazing.
Beautiful
you guys
place.
Have to go because we speak about Nigeria all the time. Mm-hmm. But our Gambian roots are very strong and very rooted.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And the best thing about Banjul for me
is jollof rice.
The jollof rice. Yeah.
The rice.
Gambia's move, jollof rice.
That is it. The
so
one
we've been eating the real McCoy because of mom.
Yes.
Love you, mom.
Love you, mama. Yeah. What is your favorite city ever?
Los Angeles.
Same here.
Los Angeles.
Same here.
All day, every day.
LA baby.
All day, I can't wait.
LA baby.
Matter of hours.
We will be back, guys. Yeah. We will be back. Martha,
LA.
Everybody, we'll be back.
LA.
Okay.
Love it.
Beyond.
Yucca.
Venice Beach.
Venice Beach.
Pasadena.
Homesick.
Homesick.
I can just see the haters vibes. Yes, okay, we love Lagos and we love Banjul too.
Yes, of course.
But it's Los Angeles for me.
Yes.
Straight up.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Okay, what was I going to ask you? Oh, you can ask me a question because I'm sure they're wondering, how are we, you know.
Actually, I don't even know. It's not a question. Observation from just sitting here.
Mm.
For me, you make this look so incredibly easy and it is far from that. Just sitting here alone, just to like the focus
yes.
and how to like make it very engaging, lively,
yes.
whatever. It's a lot of work.
Yes.
Yeah. But you make it look so effortless.
Thank you, darling.
Anyway, you are born
talent.
With it. Yeah, born with it.
You know what, Yeonju? Mm. Thank you very much, sweetheart. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. It's not, you know what it is?
Mm.
When Ula and I started,
yeah.
we didn't know what we were doing.
Yeah.
We did not know what we were doing. If mm-hmm. you see the early footage,
yeah.
you would have thought I wanted to jump into the camera. You understand? Mm-hmm. But over time, you understand me? Because I know my followers mm-hmm. and they engage with me and they leave me questions or whatever,
yeah.
I have come to that stage where I feel like I'm talking to them. So like we're in the sitting mm-hmm. room, we're gisting, we're this or whatever.
Yeah.
When I'm excited about something, I can't wait to tell them. I have an image of them because they've sent me pictures, they've sent me letters.
Gotcha.
I share their world with their families, their children, their husbands.
Yeah.
So in essence, I'm talking to them at this stage.
Gotcha.
Yes. Do you
gotcha.
See what I'm saying?
No.
Having said that, and yeah. I'm so happy my brother was here, thank you so much, guys. A million thank yous to all of you because our channel, because it's theirs, I always say that, you know what, yeah, pump right there.
Fist bump. Yeah.
Yes.
No, mad props.
That's it. It's my channel, but it's your show. And yesterday, your show hit over 1 million views. It hit over 1 million views and I am just so gum smacked because we started with only 300 views. It wasn't even that, you understand me? We had like 13 followers or something. So I am so, so grateful to you for all of the love, for all of the support. And in lieu of the 1 million views, I'm going to have a raffle draw, but that raffle draw is going to be at my masterclass. My masterclass is going to be on the 7th of December. So give or take, it's literally a month from now. And it is exclusive. Yes. First come, first serve for those 40 only. It's going to be here in London, 7th of December. It's going to be from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. Now wait for it, yet another surprise. Sister to Sister will go live for the very first time, meaning that we're going to have the masterclass, we're going to have drinks, we're going to have cupcakes, and then we are going to have 40 minutes of where you can ask me any questions, and we are going to have that Sister to Sister segment for the first time. So there are a lot of firsts in this coming to towards the end of the year, and I am so, so grateful to all of you. So I wanted to throw that out there. We are going to go on tour, hopefully in 2017 and ongoing. I will have Sister to Sister, I'll have master classes ongoing in Nigeria, in America, in LA, in Atlanta, in New York. So you know what? You guys are going to drive this bus. You're gonna drive this bus. Wherever you want me, I will be there. So you've got to get yourself together and pull up in the numbers. Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yeah, no, and
absolutely.
Nice job on the views. So.
Thank you very, very much. Now, I know a lot of girls are looking out there saying, oh, can we not have a slice of him? I already told you he'd been married.
And wait. Wait till the offers come in.
You're true. Do not try. So the least that I can do for you is that Yeonju has his own company. He's an upcoming mogul. He likes to be humble. He said, no, for me. But I consider him that. Dream big and you are big. So I'm going to leave all of his details down below in the subject box. But he owns the company Look Media in Nigeria. That is where it starts. But it is global. Whatever you guys need. As like I told you, when I put the details, you get more into detail about that. But it's a fantastic company. And they are big with the advertising. And this was really huge for my last masterclass that I had to unfortunately postpone. Anywho, like I said, I'm going to put that down below. I'm going to put up all of his
links. They know what you mean when you say anywho.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do. You know what it is? Mm. Because I speak a certain way, I know that sometimes I can come off a little too proper.
So you throw in something.
I throw in a little bit of whatever so that they can be like, you know what, Fooms is relaxed, you know, I'm this thing or whatever. I'm good. I can feel you. I relate to you. I understand. You know, because my demographic is very wide and I've got a lot of young ones.
I married you.
So that is it, guys. That is good. I just wanted you to, you know, have a little, come indoors into my family. You talk about your brothers, your sisters, your daughters so many times. And Yeonju, we don't get that opportunity all the time to be together. And I just thought, why not have a little, you know, Fab Sunday? So go out there and vote. You know, thank you so very much. Yeonju, say goodbye. Yeah,
thank you. Thank you. Eat healthy. I'm going to McDonald's right now. Keeping it real. Nice meeting you guys.
And will you come back?
She's the real deal.
Will you come back?
Anytime you want me, just let me know.
All right.
Absolutely.
Well, Yeonju is on his way to, you know, Los Angeles. So if you see him on the plane, you understand me, reach out, say hi. Okay? Love and kisses. Peace out.
Peace.